All right, Parrish, I'm going to need you to shut your mouth for 1 second here.
I'm a married man. I can't.
Parrish, you've been gone a very, very long time. And in that time, I've really taken over this company. And that's a fact that none of these idiots here can deny. Shut up! You know it's true! Every single one of you know that MPW is Blake's world! Parrish,
popcorn chicken's good.
You don't look ready for action, do you? I mean, you're out here in your sweats and your shirt and whatnot. Look, in Blake's world, you always have to be ready. Always. I'm ready. I brought my official. I say we have the match right now.
Hold on.
Before you eat that, can I have it?
You're not funny and no one likes you.
Hey, and he's fat.
You're pretty funny.
Yeah, he is.
So like I mentioned, I've been in the business for, a couple six packs. But when you talk about always being ready, well, here's my wrist tape. I know it's PG, but trust me. These are my elbow pads.
Oh, thank God. I was getting nervous.
Trust me, my wife will tell you, not all me.
Get how funny.
These are my beautiful gear that my mom did make, by the way. So if you want to have a match, well, I think now is a damn good time to have a match. Edmonton, make some noise if you want me to take the flame out of his Calgary ass.
Okay, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Blake thought he'd come out and make a spectacle of Chris Parrish, and Chris has accepted the challenge.
Initiative, that's what that's called, initiative cue.
Okay, well, we'll see whether it works in Blake's favor or not. Certainly he's got an axe to grind, so we'll see how this goes. The ref checking, oh my God, Pearl Harbor's Chris from behind, takes the boots to him.
Great way to take advantage in the match. A quick start for Blake. Parrish wasn't ready, and now he's showing it right now.
So Blake takes the rest of his gear off, and Chris gets the last of his stuff off, and the whole match starts in the corner. The two men exchanging blows. Chris fighting his way out of that corner. Gets things happening in the middle of the ring and pushes Blake back into the other corner, but Blake counters with a right of his own. And on the ropes, big forearm smash and a chop. Wow, I could hear that one all the way down here.
Parrish has been gone for a long while.
Oh, nice move by Chris. That's some veteran ring savvy there. And Blake ends up out on the outside and over the top. Wow, that's some aerial moves. I'm not used to seeing Chris
Looks like Parrish learned something new on his sabbatical from MPW.
That's for sure. So what's he going to do here? He's puts Blake up against the ring apron and another big chop. Wow. Blake making his way and Chris being warned by the ref. So he puts his man back into the ring, wants to beat him fair and square right in the middle of the ring. The two men, Blake getting to his feet, and Chris has got him in a corner. Another big chop.
He's got to get him out of the corner there, see? Oh, Parrish is this big fan favorite, doesn't break the rules. What's he doing now? You got a five count in the corner, Parrish.
Well, and
he's just grandstanding.
He's taking advantage of the five count. He's got the audience counting with him. What did he get up to there? Was that nine? And there's 10 right there. So now he throws Blake to the and goes for the quick pin. Can he get it? No.
He's not gonna beat Kannon that easily.
Blake's a tough customer. There's no doubt about it. You're gonna have to do some work if you want to beat Blake Kannon. So here we go off the ropes. No, nice counter by Blake.
Great knee.
Blake and a Blake to belly suplex. Woo! You don't want to take too many of those.
Beautifully done. So
and
just need to warm up a little bit.
Here's a pin from Blake, but no, just a count of one. Chris kicks out of that. So I'm not as familiar with Chris. I've only seen him wrestle a few times. This is kind of an opportunity for me to get to know him a little bit better. And certainly him and Blake have a bit of a history, though, and we're just kind of renewing some of their bad blood from previous eras.
When Parrish was off sowing his wrestling oats and he left MPW, Blake stayed and was working hard and getting up to the top. And now Parrish just walks in and decides he can do whatever he wants. Blake has an axe to grind. I don't blame him. And now he's showing Parrish what he's been missing, and he's showing him that this is really the Blake show.
Alright, so Blake, after shooting Paris into the corner, goes for a quick
impact?
Little pin.
Did you see that impact, Q?
That was a big impact, no doubt about it. And what's he got here? He's getting him up to his feet. And, elbow right to the back of the kidneys. Wow.
Working that back.
And another one.
Back. Getting him ready for something for sure. Taking a body part and focusing on it.
And one more. A little bit higher, that one. But wow, that's a big man coming down with an elbow there. Goes for the pin. Gets two this time.
I don't even think he wanted to pin him. He just wants to wear him down.
Good point. I think he was being pretty casual there. But so right now the offense is really in Blake's favor. He's taking him out of the corner and whips him in. Oh, nice back kick. Chris goes up to the second rope, has an elbow of his own, and a quick pin, not much of a hook. That was close, though. That was close.
Just kind of shocked. Like, come on, Kannon.
Okay, so Chris asking the crowd if they want to see him do a lion salt. Let's have a look, and this is not going his way.
Well, when you tell your opponent what you're going to do, like, how dumb are you, you manja cake? What's the matter with you, Parrish? You tell him what you're going to do and you expect him to sit there and take it?
So Blake is back on the offensive. The fans giving him something to react to.
Jealousy. It's all jealousy, Q. You know that.
And again, going after the back. You know, that Blake, he has impressed me as a wrestler. He knows his stuff, and he's a big, strong man. He's a worthy opponent for any wrestler in this company.
He doesn't waste his time catering to the fans, to the manja cakes in the crowd. He knows he's there for business, to make his check, make his money, and go.
Wow, big DDT right in the middle of the ring. Can Blake get can Chris get over and cover him? No, Blake kicks out right away. That was a big DDT that he took. That's some real veracity by Blake.
It's going to take a little more than that to take Blake out, but you're right. It was a good move.
Okay, so it looks like Chris is heading up to the top rope. He's getting the fans worked up. What's he going to do here?
Wasting time.
He's getting a little more aerial from, and Blake. Oh, wow, that's a nasty one right where it hurts.
All because he took way too much time talking. That's what Parrish is. Talk, talk, talk.
Blake, wow.
Action. Check out that spinning neck breaker that he pulled off.
And only a count of two, though. Chris was able to kick out, and you can see, though, Chris is he's reeling from that last attack. He's slow to his feet. Blake telling the ref what he thinks of him, and not sure that he likes the ref's count there. So what's he got? He's got a few shots of his own. Big forearm, and oh, wow.
Down hard on that back. Once again, Blake just trying to destroy Parrish's back. Look at this, humiliating him.
Relentless.
Just like he tried to humiliate him.
Relentless attack from Blake, and he likes to put those size 12 right into your chest or in your midsection if he can.
Right between the eyes.
That was a big fist drop there. I'm surprised he didn't get warned a little bit. Closed fist there, but that's okay. The fans are, some of the fans seem to think that should have been a three-pin, three count. I'm not sure. Referee James is a really good referee. He does a good job, and I think he called that well.
Really? Really? Good job. Yeah. Come on. He's one of the worst refs we got, but that's okay. You got to take what you get in this business.
And Blake's looking to finish him off. Oh! Caught 2 feet right up in the chin.
Too much talking, Blake. Just go after him.
But he's back on his feet. And again. Wow. How many times is he going to run into those? Oh! A little bit different that time. A little bit of a sidekick. All right, so Chris is on the offensive now. What can he make happen here? And wow!
Wow, impressive. He got the big man up in a spine buster.
So what's he going to do now? He's got him set up. He's setting something up big, I think, here. What's he going to do? Off the rope, and over he goes.
He hit that lion salt.
And what's he got? Two, and oh, that was close. That was close.
We're underestimating Blake's tenacity. He was able to kick out of that lion salt. I don't think he's done just yet.
So the fans are big fans of Chris Parrish here. They're happy to see him back at MPW. I'm happy to see him back at MPW. But he's going up to the top again. Another aerial move, or it looks like he's going to the top. Not quite sure. Yep, there he goes.
Sure is taking his sweet time.
I think, you know,
talking to the fans on the outside. Are you in a match, or are you going to talk with your buddy and have a coffee?
Here he goes, and malfunction at the junction, but he recovered. Blake managed to kick him out of that, and oh, what do we got here? Oh, beautiful counter by Blake. He was being set up for a neck breaker, and there you go with a stunner. Wow. Could this be it? This could be it. No. Wow, that was close. That was within an inch.
Should have got the three there. Didn't hook that leg strong enough. It wasn't aggressive enough on that pin, but Parrish is on his way out.
Okay, so both men stunned right now. Looks like, yeah, Blake gets to his feet a little bit quicker. He's really been controlling the majority of this match, so it's going to be tough. Chris is going to have to land something big here, maybe a big combination of moves if he really wants to win this one. So there he starts off with a high knee. And so there's a starting point. So he's starting to turn things in his way. What's he got here? Is he setting him up for a suplex?
He can't get the big man up.
And he did not get him up there. And a beautiful
flapjack counter. Flapjack by Kannon on Parrish. What a move. But what's Blake, what are you doing, man? Go pin him. So, can't waste this time.
Well, Blake's able to get to his feet quicker than Parrish. So what's he got here?
He's letting the crowd get to him. Don't listen to the manja cakes, Kannon. Just go get him.
Well, it looks like he's going to set him up here. What's he going to do? I thought he was going to give him the big size 12 in the side of the head there, but no. So he's setting him up. Looks like he's going to set him up for a suplex of his own. Oh!
Forward the suplex on Parrish. Puts him down. Still waiting for him to get up. Setting him up for the big boot. You're right there, Cuba.
I really think that, you know, if Blake can land a big move, this could be all over. It's really going to take Chris a couple of, what's he got? Oh, slingshot.
On the ropes.
Off the ropes. Wow. So he's setting him up. What's he going to do here? He's going up to the top. Wow, that's a long ways that he's going to try to come
from.
I don't know about this.
He's not going to hit that.
He's going to need wings to hit him from there. What's he got? And there he goes, and he got him. And there's the pin. And there it is. 1, 2, 3. So, ladies and gentlemen, at MPW, we take your health and safety and the health and safety of the wrestlers and referees very, very seriously. So, as you can see, we're sanitizing the ring ropes in between every single match. And there we go, ladies and gentlemen, we're underway.
Two best friends. I don't like either of these guys, these supposed best friends. But friendship's got nothing to do with getting the MPW Heavyweight Championship. And that's what this is all about, the number one contendership queue. And let's see which of these best friends has the intensity to be able to put their friendship aside and take that opportunity.
So this match is for the opportunity to have a shot at the heavyweight championship. Both of these wrestlers very deserving. Quick out of the gate for both of these guys. And ooh, is Larry setting up for his log roller? No, look at that move by Rich King to roll over and go for a quick pin.
Gonna see a lot of quick falls here. Getting ready to trying to put them away because they know each other so well. It's going to be hard. They got to get that surprise attack on each other.
That's for sure. They do know each other very well. Look at that full Nelson, but reversed by Larry Woodson into a full Nelson of his own. But look at the strength of Rich King and a snapmare to take Larry Woods down to the canvas and slow this match down a little bit.
Rich is looking a little more intense in this match. You saw at the beginning, Rich just kind of stood in the corner, was ready, he's focused. Larry pandering to the crowd. Seems like he's just another day at the office playing with his friend. But this is no game, Larry, and you better come out there to fight.
So right now, both men on the canvas in the middle of the ring, getting to their feet, and what's Rich got here? He's managed to reverse this, and he's twisting that arm, and nice takedown. And, oh, I thought he was going for a quick pin there, but no, he's got him in a headlock, and look at the leg scissors. Lumberjack Larry, very innovative wrestler. He takes advantage of any opportunity you give him. Wow, he's got those leg scissors locked in hard. Could be hard for Rich King to get out of this.
This is the kip up. Turns him around, though.
And this is the way out of it. There you go. Look at that. And goes right to the attack himself. Rich King, you know, I've seen a fire in him leading up to this match that I don't think I've seen in a while. He's really determined. He wants that gold around his waist. And woe betide anyone who stands in his way.
Larry's tasted that gold, and yeah, he knows what it tastes like. Rich hasn't yet, and he's got that drive to want to take it, take that title from whoever's champion.
So right now, Larry's got control, but Rich turns that around. Beautiful drop kick. Rich King is excellence of execution if I've ever seen it.
Definitely.
And oh, big malfunction. I think his head almost hit the steel post. What a suplex and kick out by Rich.
Didn't hook the leg, Larry. And Rich just kicked out. See, they're technical wrestlers, but you know, the heat of the moment, you lose that kind of focus that you need to be able to pull off that pin.
Yes, and so now, Lumberjack Larry going after Rich King's arm himself. What's he going to do here? Ooh, he's giving it another twist and flips him right over. Big leg drop onto that bicep. And quick pin, no. But he gets that arm again. That's good thinking by Larry Woods. He stays in control of the match.
Textbook wrestling, focus on a body part. Larry chose the arm. We'll see if that works in his favor.
This reminds me of a lot of the classic wrestlers that I used to watch when I was a kid. A lot of these same types of moves. Wow, what a backbreaker. Holy smokes.
Oh, geez, that really hurt Larry.
That sure did. And a quick pin, and look at that. Rich even locked his arm so he couldn't reach up and get to the rope. So Rich is very much thinking here. He wants this win.
Look, he's focusing on that back. Look at that knee right in the back of Larry.
Going after Larry's back. And you know, if there's a weakness that Larry has, it is his back. So what's he got here? What's he gonna lock in? Oh, what's he doing? He's locking something in here. What's
setting him up for a bow and arrow lock?
Look at that! Can he get
it?
He might get the tap out here. This is, you know, Rich King is very often wins his matches by tap out, but
just putting so much pressure.
Oh, look at that. Lumberjack Larry managed to leverage it over and get a small pin there so that Rich had to break the hold.
Luck for Larry, because if Rich could have sunk that in, there's no way Larry's back could have taken that. Both knees digging right into that lower back area.
That could have been a submission. That very much could have been a submission. So Rich King taking control of this match for now. Brings Larry into the corner. Looks like he's going to whip him out. No, reversed, and a big knee to the abdomen by Larry. And a nice kick. A spinning back kick. And there you go. Nice sequence of moves by Lumberjack Larry to gain control.
Still holding that back, though. Larry's far from getting over that back pain.
Yes, and he's in the corner now, and he's coming at Rich King, and 2 feet right to the chin. And Rich King going up to the second rope, but gets caught by Lumberjack Larry. What do we got here? Is he going to execute a powerbomb? Holy smokes, this match could be over if that's the case.
Rich King fighting out of it.
Fighting his way out of it. Because, yeah, that would be over. Ooh, wow. Rich got hit hard into that top turnbuckle, rolled out of the ring. The ref is going to check on him. I hope he's okay.
Wow, Rich looks really like he took his face first right into that turnbuckle pad. That could have been a concussion. Could have knocked himself silly.
The ref
checking on him.
The ref is still checking on him. This could be over. This could be it. If he's badly injured, this match could be over right here. And the ref has not yet gotten up. Okay, so there's Ref James. Oh, he's starting to administer the count. So I guess that's a good sign.
Looks like Rich is okay.
So Rich will be hopefully getting back to his feet and back in the ring. And Lumberjack Larry, you know, being the gentleman that he is, he's giving Rich the opportunity to get to his feet.
And giving him a chance to win the match. See, this is a mistake by Larry. He should go right at him, take advantage of it, that injury, and take him out. If he really wants to be champion, he's got to have that intensity.
So shoulder block by Rich King. And what's he going to do here? I've seen him do some beautiful moves like this. And a flying DDT. I've seen that before. Rich King is, like I said, the excellence of execution personified. Goes for the pin. And no kick out by Lumberjack Larry.
Still shaking the cobwebs loose from that head hit onto the turnbuckle, but Rich, it seems like he's ready, and he's not giving up just yet.
You know, every time that I've watched Rich King wrestle, I've seen him perform a move that I've never seen him do before. This man never ceases to amaze me. Not only is he strong and powerful, but he's got the aerial moves, and look at that as he grabs the chin and goes for that back again.
Right to the back once again. Look at this, Rich. This is a smart thing to do. He knows Larry's back is hurt. He's trying to take it out, putting that knee in there, and just wearing down that back. When your back can't move, you can't kick out.
Wow, what a move. He's got that locked right in, and again.
Calf crusher, back stretcher. I don't even know what you would call this. What an amazing move to put on.
Couple of elbows gets Larry out of trouble, though, and we're back. Back to both men on the canvas. Rich King slowly getting up, still reeling from the beating he took earlier. But Lumberjack Larry, his back is really making it, slowing him down a lot. And a beautiful leg trip. I think that was pure instinct. And now he's got him locked into a toe hold of his own. And look at that. Wow. Lumberjack Larry.
STF with the bridge by Larry. This can't be feeling good for Larry either.
Rich is
too far from the ropes.
Just reaching but can't get it. Oh, but he has to relinquish the hold because of his back.
Too much damage done by Rich already to his back. While Larry was pandering to these manja kicks in the crowd, Rich was beating him up, and now it's starting to show what that did.
So the ref counting both men. It would really be a shame if both men got counted out here. So really need to see someone come away from this and be that number one contender. So far, Lumberjack Larry manages to gain control again for now. He's got him in a front face lock, but Rich shoulder blocking him into the corner. He's going to turn this around.
More damage to that back, right to the turnbuckle.
And whoa, what a... Can he get a pin here? He might be able to get a pin. Oh, is he trying to lock in? Is this a sharpshooter he's trying to lock in? No, Cloverleaf.
Going for the Texas Cloverleaf. Another devastating back submission. If he steps over, it's over for Larry.
And looks like Larry's everything that he can to stop Rich from locking this hold in, from getting stepped over and locking it in. All Rich can, if he can get that right leg over, this, you're absolutely right, this could be over. But Larry's pulling it over to the ropes, and there you go. He's got him in there now. How is Larry with taking the pain? This is unbelievable.
So much pressure on his lower back. I don't know how he's...
He got to the rope. And the hold broken by Rich King.
That was all he could do. Larry was done. He's lucky he was close enough to the rope and got to break the hold.
So Rich King onto his feet. And looks like he's setting him up. Waiting for Larry to get up. Setting him up for something here. What's he got? Larry getting up in the corner. Rich King looks like here he comes. And makes the motion. He wants to finish it off here. And here it comes. Oh, what a reversal. And Lumberjack Larry whiff. And a reversal by Rich King.
Ooh. First DDT.
Wow. And a kick up by Lumberjack Larry.
Larry kicked out of it.
Pure, pure gut determination. There is none of that you can train for. That is one of those things that you can't teach. So the fans loving this match, and I'm loving it too. This is a great match. It's too bad one of these guys has to win, because you know this is wrestling at its best.
Come on, Q. Without a winner, there can't be a loser. Granted, these guys are putting on a great technical exhibition, but one of them's got to come through with some more intensity to be able to pull it off. This is for the championship, for a shot at the title.
And Rich coming off the top rope, misses with the flying elbow. Oh my goodness, Lumberjack Larry managed to reel him in there and get out of the way at the last second.
Well, he took way too much time getting up on those ropes, was probably enthralled by the fans saying it was a good match, and now he paid for it.
So both men being counted again. Let's see if one or both of them can get to their feet. Hopefully they can both get to their feet and finish this match off. So Rich King's up on one knee now, and Lumberjack Larry using the ropes. He's slowly getting to his feet. Both men on their feet now. Let's see who can manage to get control. Wow, what a chop by Lumberjack Larry. And another one, two-handed chop. Lumberjack Larry's getting fired up, and an elbow. But that back is still bothering him.
He's trying to fight back, but I don't know if I think he's taking too much damage.
And he's getting fired up, and the fans getting fired up. What's he got here? Is this going to be... Ooh! I don't know who got the worst of that. Well, Larry's going for the pin, but no, only a two count. Rich managed to kick out. That was close, though.
Oh, is that two?
That was close. So Lumberjack Larry on his feet.
Still pandering to the manja cakes, Larry. Go after him. Why are you giving him time to get up?
But here you go. What's he got now? If he could execute a big move here, I think any man. So what's he got? Oh, this is his big saw. Can he execute the short arm clothesline coming out of this? And no! Duck under by Rich King. What's he got? There is his Olympic slam. He has put many men away with that Olympic slam. If he can get over and just roll over and get a slight pin. But Lumberjack Larry rolls right out of the ring onto the grass.
Taking the coward's way out. Larry rolled out of the ring to avoid getting pinned. It's a smart move, I have to admit. But let's see if he gets counted out by the ref.
So... Ref James gets out of there, just gonna check on Lumberjack Larry, see how he is. Looks like he's okay. Rich King follows him out of the ring, though. And this is where, you know, Rich has got that little bit more determination. He really wants this win. He doesn't just want to count out, he wants to beat him fair and square, right in the middle of the ring, both shoulders on the canvas.
He definitely wants, it seems like he wants it more.
Small package, and Rich reverses the small package. No, neither man gets the pin. Off the ropes, here he comes, the Irish whip. No, could not execute the hip toss. What's Rich got? Backslide, can he get the pin? And no, Lumberjack Larry manages to get out of that. Log roller by Lumberjack Larry. But no, Rich turns it into a pin of his own. And did he get it? He got the pin.
Rich shows that he's the smarter and more technical wrestler. He steals that 1-on-1 from Larry, and he deserves it.
That was a beautiful move by Rich King. So Rich King will get his shot at the MPW Heavyweight Champion.